Good morning, students. In the previous video, we have almost completed the chapter number 1, that was the French Revolution. We have studied the revolution and everyday life. We were just left with the conclusion, and this conclusion is also very, very important. So in this conclusion, what is given over here? That rise and fall of Napoleon, about rise and fall of Napoleon it is being told. Napoleon Bonaparte crowned himself in 1804. He crowned himself as an emperor of France. He adopted the policy of conquest and creating new kingdoms in the expanding of his territory. This means the expansion of his territory. He believed in that policy. Initially, he was seen as a modernizer and a liberator. Initially, when he came to power, people thought about him that he is a modernizer. He loved liberty. He introduced laws like protection of private property, uniform system of weights and measures, that you will study in class 10th in detail. Later came to be viewed as invader. Obviously, afterwards, because of his policy of invasions, because his policy of expanding his territories, he was viewed as an invader. He was defeated in 1815 at Waterloo. He was defeated there, and then his measures were followed long after. But he was defeated, but still his various measures were followed. Legacy of French Revolution. What is the meaning of legacy of French Revolution? That means what French Revolution has given to the world, what the revolution granted to the world. So, ideas propagated by French Revolution like liberty and democratic rights were widely popular to Europe. So, those ideas like idea of liberty, freedom and democratic rights, that rights should be given to everyone equally. So, these were widely talked in Europe. Colonies got influenced by the ideas of freedom and worked to get out of foreign captivity. Now all the colonies, they have started getting freedom and they fought against foreign captivity. In India, in our country too, the ideas spread by French Revolution became a benchmark to attain freedom from British rule. Our leaders has also taken inspiration from the French Revolution to get freedom from the Britishers. Now I am going to give you a quick glance of the chapter, that what we have studied in this chapter, you can make a flow chart of that and you can understand the chapter thoroughly. So basically the chapter French Revolution, what it has? It has the French society during late 18th century, then the outbreak of the revolution, then France abolishes monarchy and becomes a republic. Then did women have a revolution? Then the abolition of slavery, the revolution and everyday life. So these are all the topics in a proper sequence I have told you. These are all the topics that we have studied in this chapter. So social setup. In social setup, we have studied about first, second, third estate. First, clergy. Second, nobility. Third, comprised of big businessmen, rich peasants and small peasants and workers. Then we have studied the struggle to survive. That was only of the third estate. Others were not struggling at all. Then we have studied about growing middle class demanding and its and to privileges. So we have studied that middle class was growing and it was demanding against the privileges given to two classes. When we studied about the outbreak of revolution, in the outbreak of revolution, we have studied about the events that happened. Events that happened, that how that revolution broke out, that what happened at that time. Then after that revolution, we have studied France become a constitutional monarchy. So in that drafting of French constitution, it completed in 1791. We have studied that. Then we have studied that France abolishes monarchy and becomes a republic. When, if you remember, when Louis XVI went into secret negotiation with Prussia, then National Assembly attacked Prussia and Austria, then it declared itself a republic. Then we have studied about Robespierre. We have studied the reign of terror started. these things were the outcome of the revolution, that what happened after the revolution, because life has not stopped only on after the revolution. Then we have studied about reforms by Robespierre, then a directory rules France, where Jacobins' fall was there. New constitution took away voting rights. We studied those things. Then we have studied about women, that did women have a revolution. Then we have studied about slavery, the abolition of slavery. Firstly, it was abolished, then it was reintroduced, then finally it was abolished. Then we studied about the revolution and everyday life. It is also very, very important. Then we at last studied about the French Revolution and the and its legacy, that legacy of French Revolution we have studied. So this chapter is of very much importance, and I will give you questions that will be broadcasted in your assignment slot in the DAV website. I will give you questions for 1 mark, question for 3 marks, question for 5 marks. Those are the important questions from the chapter. You are supposed to make your notebook, and your notebook should have an index. First page should be devoted to index. If the index is printed in your notebook, that is well and good. If not printed, you will make that index. In that, we will have a serial number, chapter number you will have, or a date you will have, and then topic, and then signatures, page number and signature you will have. So these things there will be, and you will complete those questions. I will put those questions today only, and maybe they will be broadcasted tomorrow or day after tomorrow. So it is all about today's video. Thank you and have a nice day. Tomorrow we are going to start a new chapter.